student days, I used to hate tutor courses and communal courses. And ultimately, that thought process in me led me to be a member of the Communist Party of India in 1958, when I had just completed 18 years of age. Since that time, my political activities were guided by Marxism, communism. I strongly believed in class struggle. I was impressed by a speech of Ambedkar made in the Constituent Assembly, and he said, unless the difference between rich and poor is narrowed, the democracy will go to hell. Constitution will be thrown to the waste paper basket. So therefore, I joined the communist movement, but later on I found the communist movement is becoming weak and weak. The communist party was not able to penetrate into the minds of the youth and students. Therefore, I thought that being a member of the communist party, I cannot fight against feudal forces, against communal forces. Therefore, after deep consideration, maybe because of my party's alignment to the Communist Party was there, and my faith in socialism was very strong, and because of my family background, I decided to join the Congress Party of India, the Indian National Congress. And in 2004, I joined the Congress Party. In that party's ticket, I was elected to the Odisha Legislative Assembly from Loisinga constituency. And I was nominated as the deputy leader of Odisha Legislative Party under the leadership of Janaki Varla Patnaik. And I have been continuing to be a disciplined soldier of the Indian National Congress. Whatever post has been given to me, whatever work has been entrusted to me, I have done it to my utmost satisfaction. And certainly, the Congress Party, by that, has been able to impress many people. I am trying my best to strengthen the Congress Party just to eradicate communal forces. I will appeal to the students and youth to join the Indian National Congress, be an active member, fight against communal forces and feudal forces, fight for the right of the peasants, of the workers, unemployed youth, exploited women, and misgivings of the society as a whole. There are many thoughts among the people nowadays because of the false propaganda of BJP and BJD at the center and the state. People are not able to protect their own right. Therefore, through social media, we should penetrate into the mind of the people. Social media is very active now. My young friends taking more interest in social media than the regular print media or electronic media. They should successfully reach the people, everybody in the society, impress them about the Congress ideology, impress them about the consequence that is going to happen if our message doesn't go to the people. Democracy will be lost. Individual liberty will be severely affected, and the rich will ultimately exploit